الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والأرض ربنا ما خلقت هذا باطلا سبحانك فقنا عذاب النار.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام الأتمان الأكملان على خير خلق الله أجمعين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala abundantly the way he deserves to be praised. And we ask Allah to exalt the mention and grant peace and send his blessings and salutations upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, his companions, wives, and all those who follow them on their path of righteousness until the day of recompense. Brothers and sisters, I am beyond excited to begin and initiate this wonderful project and this adventure that I would like you to join me on, insha'Allah ta'ala. And this adventure is one that fulfills many objectives and purposes. It is something that is so important, so demanding, so crucial for our well-being in this world and in the life to come. And it's actually a manifestation of the purpose of life. It is the embodiment of why we were created. And Islam fundamentally always deals with the basics and lays down the foundations upon which you can understand yourself and the environment and the reason why you're here, where you're going, and how to get there. And I find this interesting because we are living in times where there's a major disconnect between the people and the creator of people. And we always strive and aim and encourage ourselves, first and foremost, and others to reconnect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because that connection is the only way one can attain happiness in this world and in the life to come. You don't want to miss out on either. You don't want to live this life where you're having plenty of entertainment on the expense of missing out on the good things and the virtues and the blessings Allah prepared for the believers in the life to come. And you don't want to also live miserable in a sense, just in preparation for the life to come, that you miss out on understanding and enjoying the things that Allah Azza wa Jal made lawful. So one of the greatest things that brings happiness to the soul is the remembrance of the Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Most High. It is the ladder through which the soul ascends. It is the adornment through which the soul becomes beautiful and the equipment through which the soul strengthens. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا وَسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا. O you who have believed, remember Allah abundantly. Remember Allah abundantly. And then glorify His perfection in the morning and in the evening. And this is the crux of the matter. And this is the foundation of this project. And this is the very thing that we want to dig into to such a level, perhaps that has not been done before in the English language, so that we can understand why do we remember Allah? And what are the virtues of remembering Allah? And what are the etiquettes of remembering Allah? And what are the benefits of remembering Allah? And then most importantly, the meanings of the adhkar, which we learn from the Quran and from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because many times, because of language barriers, especially for those who Arabic is not their mother language or their mother tongue, we might memorize certain adhkar, what we know as the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal, or the things that you mention in the morning, the mentioning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or celebrating the mention of Allah. But we don't know what we're saying. And when we don't know what we're saying, we are missing out on that sweetness that is a byproduct of the heart and the tongue being in perfect harmony upon remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the objective. That we don't only want to, like parrots, just repeat what we have learned, but we want to understand and mean it so that whenever we engage in this dhikr, whenever we remember Allah in the various conditions and times that are legislated, you actually will feel your iman growing. You will understand Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more. You will become familiar with the greatness of the Creator. And no one did this better than the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so we will follow his footsteps in understanding and in the way he explained certain virtues and benefits to the Sahaba. May Allah be pleased with them and all those who follow them on their path until the last day. So Allah Azza wa Jal tells us also that if we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will succeed. Remembering Allah brings about tremendous benefits. It is means for us to be saved from the punishment. It is means for us to get closer to Allah. It is means for us to understand who Allah is. It is means for us to increase our provision. It is means for us to become better prepared for the life to come. And I will mention, inshallah, at some point, a list, a long list of benefits and virtues that when we come to the realization that we've been missing out on them for most of our lives, they would be major regret. But we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we thank Him for giving us the opportunity to take heed and to take action and to do something about it, to rectify our heedlessness and our forgetfulness and our distance from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala by acknowledging that we have shortcomings and then having an action plan to correct ourselves so that we can examine our lives, as they say, before and after. You know, people love this before and after. They have a picture of a person before they lost weight and after they lost weight. But you will never find a picture of someone before remembering Allah and after remembering Allah, or, you know, something of the sort. Because that's something that is not necessarily visible physically, even though the scholars say the person who remembers Allah often, there will be illumination of light on that person's face. They will illuminate. They will have this special kind of light that Allah Azza wa Jal gives. It's a divine type of light that Allah grants those who are close to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah to make us among them. And so even though there isn't a physical change per se, even though some may have it, the internal, the heart, the polishing of the heart will be in that great condition. And so I look forward, inshallah, to addressing those one by one. But before so, I just want to mention a couple of things or a couple of quotations from the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, said, "Those that remember Allah have fled with all good things." Everything that is good, those who remember Allah kind of took it and went away. And in the upcoming episodes, inshallah, we will be discussing more about what the Sahaba said and we will dig deeper into the subject matter. I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make this a source of benefit for me and for you and for all the Muslims. هذا والله أعلم وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والأرض ربنا ما خلقت هذا باطلا سبحانك فقنا عذاب النار